In the past several decades, there's been a movement to a more learner-centered approach to classroom practice with a de-emphasis on teacher-led instruction. This presentation will provide an overview to an alternative approach labeled constructivism. My name is Bill Hewitt, and I'm Professor Emeritus at Valdosta State University and Adjunct Professor at Capella University. The presentation is narrated by Jeff Hewitt, who is assisting me with the production of these videos.
In the presentation on constructivism, I mentioned that the teacher-led approach to instruction was based primarily on three learning theories: operant conditioning with a focus on consequences, cognitive information processing with a focus on memory, and social learning theory with a focus on observation. Additionally, the assessment of knowledge and skills was primarily the use of standardized paper-pencil exams. The instructional approach of constructivism is based on a wider variety of learning theories where John Dewey, Jean Piaget, Lev Vygotsky, and Jerome Bruner are the most often mentioned. A variety of instructional theories are often included under the rubric of constructivism, such as discovery learning, inquiry-based learning, problem-based learning, project-based learning, situated learning, experiential learning, and self-regulated learning. Each of these has a separate learning theory. In fact, as was mentioned in the presentation on connectivism, some practitioners believe that this is a constructivism theory applied to interacting with digital networks and knowledge bases. The commonalities among these different theories when applied to instruction include a focus on inquiry and exploration, an emphasis on problem-solving and project-based learning, and the creation of products or services. In the case of connectivism, there is an added focus on connecting to networks of people and knowledge bases. It is important to also consider the influence of the humanists and the positive psychologists on the development of constructivism, with their focus on the importance of emotions in the learning process. One of the most generic approaches to creating constructivist lessons was produced by Dunn and Larson and is summarized by Hewitt as shown in the references. It consists of 11 steps sorted into four categories: investigation, invention and initial implementation, further implementation and evaluation, and celebration. Investigation includes three steps. The first step is contextualizing where the teacher explains the process to the whole class and either shares an essential question that begins the inquiry process or has learners create an essential question for the topic of investigation. The teacher then works with students in small groups to help them connect the students' previous experiences to the essential question. The next step is clarifying, where the students discuss the project among themselves in small groups, and the teacher facilitates these discussions as learners determine what they already know and what they need to know in order to complete the project. The third step in the investigation category is inquiring, where students begin the process of acquiring the necessary knowledge and skills they might need to complete the project. Teachers facilitate by asking questions and helping students identify and understand credible resources. The next category, invention and initial implementation, has two steps. The first is planning. This requires the students in each group to begin to organize or reorganize their knowledge and develop some initial plans as to how to approach the project. Learners then take the next step of realizing where they develop a first draft or beginning product or service that will meet the stated criteria for the project. Each small group will develop an original approach, and no two will look exactly alike. The third category of further implementation and evaluation includes four steps. At this point, groups check their project against the criteria to see if it meets the specifications. It is expected that the first attempt will need some or several modifications. The second step is modifying, where students rework their project in terms of deficiencies they may have identified. They then retest and modify until they have a finished project that meets the stated criteria. The next step in this category is interpreting. This step requires students to describe the value of the project relative to their backgrounds and experience. This is the point at which each learner in the group considers the personal value of the project. Finally, students engage in reflecting, where they broaden their evaluations of the project and put it in larger context, especially as it might be valuable to others. The last category of celebration includes only one event. At the end of the learning experience, students present their projects to the larger group, while the larger group acknowledges the value of the efforts and results of the group. Notice that throughout this set of events, which might take several days or weeks, the teacher is involved more in organizing and facilitating than engaged in direct instruction. However, direct instruction can be included at various steps in the process. The flipped classroom approach is one way to do this. In this approach, short videos that provide direct instruction on a topic are viewed at home. These could be produced by the classroom teacher or a presentation created by another teacher, such as those available at Khan Academy could be used. Class time is then used for active inquiry and the creation of products and services. The set of videos by Hewitt and Vernon describe how this can be done. Two additional instructional models developed within the constructivistic approach include the 5E model created to address the National Science Education Standards, and the Artful Learning model developed by Leonard Bernstein to address inquiry through the arts. The 5E model incorporates 5 stages. The first stage is engagement, where the learners are actively involved in identifying or understanding an essential question and analyzing what they already know and what they need to know. They might also identify some steps to take to begin the learning process. The second stage is exploration, where learners begin to inquire and develop the initial knowledge and skills needed to address the problem or project that is the focus of the learning process. The third stage is explanation. This involves learners answering why questions about any understandings or relationships they may have identified. At this point, it is likely that new questions or issues might be identified that require additional exploration. The fourth stage is elaboration. This involves some initial applications of their knowledge and skills. At this point, learners are encouraged to create new methods of exploring the needed knowledge or skills, as well as creating initial products or services that would address the essential question. The fifth stage is evaluation, where both learning and products or services that have been developed are critiqued. This might involve such assessment procedures as portfolio assessment that includes artifacts created through the learning process, performance assessment, where the learners demonstrate what they have learned and show any products or services they may have developed, or concept maps that provide explanations and demonstrate relationships among factors related to the inquiry process. The Artful Learning model is slightly different and involves 4 phases. The first is experience, where learners interact with and respond to a masterwork that can take many forms, such as piece of art, a dramatic skit, a movie clip, an example of architecture, a mathematical formula, and so forth. The basic concept is that the masterwork can serve as a catalyst for engaging learners in active learning. The next phase is inquire, which is essentially the same as discussed in other approaches to constructivistic learning. This begins by identifying a significant or essential question that serves to guide the inquiry. In this approach, there is an emphasis on using interdisciplinary explorations and an emphasis on deep inquiry. The third phase is create. At this point, learners first create a prototype and then further refine the product through evaluation and revision. The fourth and final phase is reflect. At this point, learners consider both the learning experience as well as the impact of the created product or service to themselves and others. When one compares these different models of constructivism, it becomes apparent that they have a lot in common with the general model associated with connectivism, especially to the current version that has evolved from the original conceptualization. The major difference is that connectivism adds the element of a digital network to the learning process. For example, the connectivist model would first have learners engage with material, either individually or in groups, with essential or significant questions that have been presented via digital technology, and the inquiry process would be completed via a digital network. Learners would engage in discussions over the network to organize or reorganize their current knowledge and understandings. They would then produce, either individually or in groups, a prototype of a product or service that is in a digital format that would address the essential question. The individual or group would then test and critique the first iteration of the product or service and would continue to revise until it was ready to be implemented via the digital network. The next step would be to share the product or service and to collect data on how it was used and reflect on the process of development and implementation. The last step would be some sort of celebration or recognition of the effort that had been expended and the learning that had occurred, both individually and as a group. It is important to understand that no one is likely to become an expert in any form of constructivism, especially not at the beginning of one's professional practice. At this point, it is merely necessary to review the different approaches and select one that appears to most relevant to the content and learners that you are most likely to use initially. Most importantly, educators should implement the basic principles of constructivism, engage learners in inquiry and exploration, provide opportunities for learners to gain experience in problem-solving and project-based learning, and have learners create products and services that are meaningful to them. And because digitalization is such an important part of modern society, have learners connect to digital networks, both for consuming information as well as contributing to their development. Doing so will be an important component of your professional development.